Hello. Unfortunately, when I recorded this, the camera recorded audio from its own built-in mic rather than the wireless lapel mic that I was wearing. So I'll do my best with the audio, but I might jump in with a voiceover like this at some point.
Your view is from Plot Center. The quality might not be great because it's getting a little bit dark out, but hopefully you can still see things okay. I'm going to take the time now to measure the distance, to measure out 7.98 meters, and this tree behind me is the one that's facing northward. Then I'm going to sweep in a clockwise direction. And first I'm just going to flag all of the trees that are within that 7.98 meter radius. Normally you would measure them at the same time, but I'm going to flag them all first and then come back and measure them. This distance here is 7.98 meters away, so all trees that have their center within this distance, I'm going to flag them. Okay, and this is just a little bit past 8 meters, so this big nook is further out. Okay, so I flagged all the trees that are within our 7.98 meter radius plot. I put flagging around all of them except for that big Douglas fir over there. I don't think I could reach all the way around it, so I just put a piece of flagging on the front, and I've numbered them all. I'm going to give you the species and the DBH now. I'm going to start at tree number one. Breast height is 1.3 meters, or if you're in the U.S., 4.5 feet, which is not quite the same. So that adds a little bit of an interesting twist. And I'm going to measure from the uphill side here. And I'm being careful to keep my tape level. And I'm crossing it over before I measure that zero mark. I'm going to just measure to the nearest centimeter for this exercise. So this first tree number one, is a western hemlock and is 34 centimeters in diameter. And it is a live tree. Tree number two is a Douglas fir. It is 42 centimeters in diameter, and it is live. Tree number three was a western, red cedar. It is a snag, it is a dead tree. I'll do the DBH first, and I'll come back later and do the decay class. So the snag has a DBH of 21 centimeters. That's tree number three. Tree number four is a western red cedar. It has a DBH of 41 centimeters. And it is a live tree. Tree number 5 is a Douglas fir. It is 52 centimeters in diameter, and it is a live tree. Also a Douglas fir. A little hard to figure out where breast height is since this one's a little bit mounded. Go for about here. It is leaning a little bit, so I'm going to do the DBH tape perpendicular to the lean, so that I don't overestimate the diameter. This Douglas fir is 82 centimeters in diameter, and it is a live tree. Tree number 7 is a Western hemlock. Centimeters diameter. Tree number 8, Western red cedar, measured from the uphill side. DBH of 52 centimeters. It is a live tree. This was a Western red cedar. It is also a snag. Tree number 9. Centimeters DBH. That's the end of the trees. Let's figure out the decay classes for those snags. I'm going to get my reference packet to look at that. I'll share this with you so you can look at it. So I'll start with number 9, the one I did last. So the branches have pretty much all broken off. There's a little bit of area that has no bark, but most of the bark is still on there, so let's see. And it has snapped off. It's hard to tell what the original height was. Let's see. And is it hard or spongy? It's got some rot, but it's still pretty hard. So I think we're probably in stage 5 there, maybe stage 6. We'll call it stage 5, even though the top is broken off. It still is relatively solid. Okay, so we'll say decay class, tree class 5. Alright. Oh, and for all of the live trees, we can just write tree class 1. All of the... I could have said asked you whether they were healthy or unhealthy. All of the trees that aren't snags in this plot look in pretty good condition, so everything that isn't a snag is in class 1. Alright, so tree number 3 here. This one is more decayed. The wood is kind of spongy and soft. So I think I'm going to put... I'd call it spongy, so we're going to call this tree class 6. So number 3, I think we said this was a Western red cedar as well, is going to be in decay class 6. Now let's try to do some heights. This is going to be a little bit tricky. These are tall trees, and a rule of thumb is that you want to be at least as far away from the tree as the tree is tall. I think I'm probably not going to measure all of the trees that I suggested because I'm running a little bit short on time, but we'll try to get a pretty good estimate of the overall height of these trees in this plot. Okay. I think I'm going to try this Douglas fir here. So I'm going to walk out until I can see the top of the tree, and I think I'm about at least as far away as the tree is tall. And then I will note the distance and measure on my clinometer from the percent scale.
My microphone wasn't working when I was out there, so I'll just quickly say that my Eslon tape was only 30 meters long, so once I got out to 30 meters, I should have reeled it in and then gone out further to get at least one height away from the tree, but I didn't have time to, given the constraints. The problem is that when you're using your clinometer, once you get up to around 100% slope or above, you lose your precision really quickly, and it's hard to make an accurate measurement of height.
So in case my microphone wasn't picking up from that far away, this is tree number 2. I stood 30 meters away from it. My lower clinometer reading was -1%, and my upper clinometer reading was 146%. So to figure out the height, we do the upper reading, 146, minus the lower reading, which was -1. So 146 minus -1 is 147. So it's 147% of 30 meters. So I'll let you do the math and figure that out. And ideally, I'd measure the heights of a few trees. The snags here are a little bit shorter. Most of the mature trees were probably pretty close to that height. The big Douglas fir, I can see, is definitely a bit taller. This small hemlock, this smaller cedar might be a little bit smaller, but I think for the moment, for the live trees, we can just use the same height as for tree number 2 for an estimate for volume. So ideally, we'd get better measurements if we measured the height of all of the trees, or at least of a few different trees, but we'll stick with this for now. Okay, and I'm going to do a prism sweep. I'm going to stand just to the side of plot center, because you folks are right at plot center. But I'm going to keep my prism at plot center, and I'm going to do a sweep. I'm going to start pointing in the direction of tree number 1, that western hemlock that I'm pointing to right now. That tree is just out. So remember, whether a tree is in or out in the prism is not related to whether it was in or out in our fixed radius plot, because a prism is using variable radius sampling. So a big tree could be much further out and still be in, where a small tree has to be closer. So our tree number 1 is not in, and you don't need to mark those down on the sheet. We're just counting. So, okay, that Douglas fir behind it is also not in. I'm going to try to keep my prism right at about plot center. This Douglas fir that I'm pointing to here, that we did measure, is definitely in. So that's one tree in. So one Douglas fir. Keep track of which species, too, because we'll divide this by species, and I might not be able to keep track of it in my head. Okay, I'm continuing to sweep, and I'm trying to rotate me around plot center. Okay, that hemlock that we measured back there, that is in. So we have one Douglas fir and one hemlock in. The Douglas fir that I'm pointing at here, that we measured, is definitely in. So, two Douglas fir, one hemlock. The monster Douglas fir is definitely in, so three Douglas fir, one hemlock. This hemlock that we measured is in, so three Douglas fir, two hemlock. The western red cedar that we measured is in. So three Douglas fir, two hemlock, one western red cedar. The western red cedar snag is in, so why don't you mark one western red cedar snag, but we'll keep that separate from the trees. So I think we had two Douglas fir for living trees. We had three Douglas fir, two hemlocks, one cedar. And that big Douglas fir that's farther out that wasn't quite in is also in our prism. So if I haven't miscounted, I think we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 Douglas fir, one, two hemlock, and one western red cedar that we're in. So write those down. Our basal area factor of this prism is 10. So you should be able to figure out the total basal area, our estimate of total basal area, as well as our estimate of basal area per species. So I'd like you to figure those things out on your own.